I am Dr. Ashwini Deshpande, and in this video, I will explain IIR filter structures. There are four types of IIR filter structures: direct form 1, direct form 2, cascade form, and parallel form. An IIR filter structure or a block diagram representation can be drawn using a constant coefficient difference equation form or a transfer function form, that is h of z. The block diagram representation makes use of basic functional units as an adder, multiplier, and delay unit. Let us see an example of how to draw an IIR filter structure. In this difference equation, output depends upon two past output samples and one present input samples. A and B denotes the filter coefficients respectively. This expression can be drawn with the help of block diagram as it comprises of two delay units, two adder units, and three multipliers. Thus, we obtain an output y of n from a present input, which is getting multiplied to b0 filter coefficient, plus a1 into y of n minus 1 plus a2 into y of n minus 2. Direct form 1 structure can be realized using a difference equation as given in this expression. From this expression, we can directly draw a direct form 1 structure where we are declaring one intermediate variable V of n. Thus, an intermediate signal V of n is a function of past input samples, present input samples, and the corresponding input coefficients, and the total output y of n is obtained from an intermediate signal v of n and the collection of past output samples which are multiplied with associated filter coefficients. Direct form 1 structure can also be obtained from its z domain representation. In the z-domain representation, the total transfer function h of z is splitted into two subsystems, h2 of z, h1 of z. One of the subsystem represents 1 upon the denominator polynomial, other subsystem represents a numerator polynomial. The intermediate signal v of n, which we have seen in the previous slide, its z transform can be expressed as h1 of z into x of z signal. Thus, by taking the inverse z transform, v of n can be expressed in terms of x of n minus k and pk coefficients, and the total output in terms of the z domain is thus obtained from V of z multiplied with H2 of z. So the entire Y of z thus once again can be expressed in time domain as a function of V of n and Y of n minus k terms. A direct form 1 structure thus requires total m plus n plus 1 number of multipliers, m plus n number of adder terms, and m plus n number of delay units. In order to obtain the direct form 2 structure, the idea is to interchange the order of the two subsystems h1z and h2 of z in the h of z transfer function form. So in this form, H1Z is taken up as an earlier form as that counts for the BK constants or the coefficients, and H2 of Z that counts for the AK coefficients. Once again, during this interchange of the ordering of H1Z and H2Z, we declare an intermediate signal now as W of N. The term W of N is expressed in terms of X of N input terms and the delayed WN terms getting multiplied with the AK constants or the coefficients. The Z transform representation of W of N thus is considered to be H2 of Z multiplied with X of Z. So WN and WZ are the Z transform pair, and the total Y of Z is thus expressed in terms of delayed WN terms multiplied with the BK constants. The basic idea behind the interchange of the subsystem of H of Z is to share the delay elements between the two subsystems. Thus, we can see that in the direct form 2 implementation, an entire delay link is been shared between the input section and output section of this realization, which leads to reduction in the delay units as compared to the direct form 1 implementation. The direct form 2 realization can be obtained for the transfer function given in this example, such as a direct form 1 implementation, which is obtained by splitting the term H of Z into two subsystems as H1Z and H2Z. H1 of Z relates to the input polynomial, the numerator polynomial, and 1 upon denominator polynomial is what is H2 of Z. Thus, when we interchange the order of the both subsystems, we can see that we are able to share the delay line between both input and output subsection. Thus, the direct form 2 implementation requires one delay element less as compared to the direct form 1 realization. Cascade form is the next type of IIR filter structure representation, where it is required to factorize the given transfer function into a smaller subsections, where all the subsections they are arranged in a multiplicative form. These multiplicative subsections then are arranged in a series connection, which leads to less feedback error as compared to an entire H of Z transfer function implementation in direct form 1 or direct form 2. Thus, a generalized form of a transfer function required for the cascade form of implementation is the factorized form of the given H of Z. Using this form, we can obtain the cascade form where each subsection is either the first order or second order subsection, which is expressed with the help of direct form 2 realization. Looking at the example, the given transfer function, which is factorized for the numerator polynomial and the denominator polynomial in the direct form 1 implementation, within the cascade structure, each of this factorized form represents a first order system. Whereas in the cascade structure, which uses a direct form 2 implementation of the same, it requires less number of delay elements as compared to the earlier form. Preferably, it is suggested to make use of a subsections of second order as compared to the first order. The next type of realization is the parallel form of realization, where the given transfer function is arranged as a summative or an additive kind of the subsections. These additive subsections are obtained by applying partial fraction expansion on the overall transfer function. Thus, all the additive subsections, they are arranged in a parallel form, and to this arrangement a common input is fed as x of n. Since this realization accepts input x of n at a time, it performs faster computation of filtering as compared to the earlier forms. Example shows how we can factorize the given transfer function and how we can arrange the factors in the parallel implementation. Thus, the parallel implementation speed up the computation. Looking at a generalized example of a given transfer function, we can see how using partial fraction expansion, the given transfer function of rational form is splitted into two additive subsections, and these additive subsections, they are arranged in a parallel form of implementation. This parallel form of implementation can as well be arranged with the first order sections. The previous slide shown the second order subsections, whereas this realization shows the first order sections in the parallel form of implementation. Again, it is preferably arranged as a second order subsections. Thank you.